Hi everyone, Liz here. Thanks for stopping by. So I've got a little package today to show you. And this one has come to me from the good people at paintsomeway.com. I've been doing some fantastic special drill projects that they've sent me as part of PR packages for Smashing the Special Six. So I thought I'd better order some more to keep my hand in to make sure I've got plenty more projects to do once Smashing the Special Six is finished. But yeah, these are two brand new items and then they're just a little quirky, you know, and I'm like with my little extra quirky bits. So they are new items. Let me get them out. We have this one. Oh, both of them have come out together. So that is two items there. So brand new products that I've just seen. And then my extra little bit. Okay, so we'll look at those in a moment. As always, there are some fantastic special offers on at Paint Some Way at the moment. Spend over $49 and you get free shipping. Spend over $30 and you get a free gift. Yay! So do go and check them out. I'll put you some screenshots of the special offers that there are at the moment. And as always, if you are watching this at a future date, then just double check if the offers are still on, because the offers that I mention are what are current when I make my video. So I just saw this. I do like collecting all the little quirky, little different diamond painting pens. And this is a lovely rose pink diamond painting pen. I've got a bit of sellotape stuck to my finger. What am I doing? Nobody said I was professional. You could put it on a keychain or put it around your neck because it's got a nice little loop there. Look, that sellotape's still stuck there. Get off. Honestly, must be wanting to join in with my unboxing. It's saying, I'm a star, I'm on film. And then the little end just pops off and it's just a single placer on that end. It's very, very light. So if you don't like heavy diamond painting pens, this is a really light one. Let me see if a little squishy will fit on it. I'm thinking possibly it will. Yep, so that doesn't really go, does it? It wants a nice hot pink one on there. So if you do prefer to have something a little bit softer to grip when you're diamond painting, then you can use your pen grips, your little squishies, and they will go on there as well. But yeah, I just think sometimes it's nice, just when you're diamond painting, just to have something a little bit posher than just one of your pink pens. So yeah, we've got a nice little pen. Put the right end on, Liz. Honestly, no good am I. Okay, and the price of this one was just $1.50. So yeah, but I'm quite surprised how light that is. That is really good. And I do like the fact, actually, that you could tie that round your neck. I do think the amount of times that I forget where things are and I lose things and I put things down and turn back round and it's disappeared, that having something that hangs around my neck is probably a really good idea. Okay, so that is a lovely, and I like the colour as well. It's not hot pink, but it's a very dusky pink. Very nice. Okay, so I'm going to look at the item underneath here first. And this is, ooh, look at that, spooky Halloween. So it was in the new items. I always like to go and look in the new things when I'm choosing items to show you, because there's some really exciting, fantastic stuff coming out at the moment. I just think we're so lucky. When I first started diamond painting, there wasn't that many different things to buy. It was more, you just got your straight canvas, and there wasn't the special shaped drills, there wasn't the sparkler drills. You did get some crystals on ones. I know the first set of cards I did had crystals on. But then as the years have gone on, we seem to have built up more and more as it's got more into a hobby, and people are wanting to do different things. All different ideas are coming out and there's some fantastic ones. And yeah, I'm just enjoying doing them still so much. Okay, so we have a basic toolkit, pen, board and wax. We are all crystals. Oh, and there's some specials in there as well. We've got a very nice chain. I still haven't found out what this chain's called. Is it a curb chain? Is it a rope chain? I got this on one something I did the other day, didn't I? It's like very, very sort of small squares all joined together. Is it a, oh, I can't remember. I will look it up one day. Maybe you'll know what it is. But yeah, that's quite a nice chain. And it's a good solid chain as well. So it'll hang on the wall. It'll keep your little plaque on the wall. And then we've got the a great lobster claw clasps, my favourites. Lobster claws because they look like a lobster claw coming after you. Oh dear. Yeah, I think they're just the easiest to use because you've just got the little lever on the back to slip things through. You're not having to get like three friends and an elephant to try and open one of those ring ones, you know, where you've got to part it and get your little keychain bit through the ring to slot it round. Yeah, so that's, they're definitely my favourites. Good long length as well. But this is the star of the show. Look at that. That is fabulous. Do you know, actually, I might put lights around this as well. I've got some little tiny LED lights. And I think if I just maybe sellotape from the back, tape from the back, and just put it all the way around the edge, it'll just make this glow and make this face here glow. Ooh. Actually, I mean, he looks a little bit sort of naughty, doesn't he? But he looks really smiley. Have you ever seen a ghost smiling? Wow, he's definitely got a smiley face. So it's like a plate. You don't have to use the chain to hang it up if you don't want to. There are the two little holes there, look, to hang it up. But if you want to, you could just pop this on the wall like a plate, or you could stand it up. If you've got, you know, one of those little plate stands or something, you could stand it up in one of those, actually, with a little tea light behind it. An electric one. Oh, sorry, a battery-powered one. Electric. How posh am I? Electric tea lights. No, a battery-powered tea light. I wouldn't put naked flames anywhere near diamond paintings. It would probably shine through the orange and the yellow there, and it would look really, ooh, like your pumpkin's actually lit. That's quite a good idea. I like that idea. Might have to look into that. Depends where it goes. That's the trouble. I've got to rearrange this year as to where everything's going. Because, yeah, I think the little corner where I used to put everything is probably going to be full. So, but this is just lovely. And then you've got all your branches growing around the edges. So it's like your pumpkins in the middle of the branches and the ghosts just coming up and going, ooh. Yeah, you're not going to be scared of that, are you? He's just, I mean, if he jumped out at you and said, boo, yeah, you probably would jump. But, yeah, if he smiled at you like that, you're not going to be frightened. To be honest, the way my hair looks today, if he jumped out at me, he'd probably scream and run off. Because, yeah, I'm definitely rocking the drag through a hedge backwards look today. Okay, so this one at the moment on the website is $6.99. We'll give it a quick measure. I think it's probably about 9-ish inches, do we think? Let me have a look. It's a 19 centimetres, 7.5 inches. So, oh, it's a nice little one then. Oh, wow, that's really good. And it is, yeah, it is acrylic. I was thinking when I first picked it up it was wood, but no, it's a nice thick acrylic there. You've got the same design on the back. So if you wanted to hang it in a window, you will, the person at the other side of the window will still get the design. It's got this cover sheet on the back. What they tend to do with anything that's acrylic is you've got your cover on the front where your gems go and where all your sticky is. And then they put a cover on the back to stop scratches and fluff sticking to the back. So you just take that off when you've finished. Yeah, I just thought these are super. I say it again, there is quite a few in the set, a few different ones. So if you want to get more than one, you could make a little scene with them. But I just think that's super. I really like that one. Let's have a look at these gems. Oh, I do like my specials. And anybody that watches me and has been watching me a while, well, no, I love my specials. I don't do other things as well, I promise. But we are in Smashing the Specials, so I've just got anything special drill on the brain. And I do find that I get to a point where I've done so many canvases. You know, there's only so many that you can give to other people. And there's so much wall space I've got. So I like doing the little projects. And with it coming up to Halloween and then Christmas, I've got a lot to do. So,
yay. Keep checking them out.
Ooh, right, so it's not many colours. It's only 7 different ones. So we have a lovely, a clear crystal. I think the ghost is going to be clear crystal. Actually, it might be quite nice in a glow-in-the-dark. Ooh, how about that? Putting glow-in-the-dark drills on the little ghost. And then I have got actually some glow-in-the-dark orangey ones left from last year, little gems. That I could maybe put it in the mouth and the eyes of the pumpkin. So if I've got a light behind it, then when it comes dark, they'll all glow. Ooh. I'm trying to scare hubby. What can I say? He'll probably just look at it and say, what on earth's that? But anyway, he's not easily impressed. We've got some lemon crystals there. We've got a honey gold crystal and a very nice dark orange crystal. And then a little bit of like a browny colour crystal and a pale peachy orangey crystal. And then, ooh, the fire red orange ones. So they've got an iridescent coating on them, and that's number 7. So it goes all the way around the edge of your little plate, of your little plaque there. So, oh, that's going to look fantastic when it's done. Yay. Can't wait. Thank you for everybody that adds on suggestions as well. When things away. Yeah, when I've done my videos, quite often people pop in the comments suggestions of things that I could do as well as things that I mentioned. So thanks. I mean, I love reading all your comments, and you come up with some fantastic ideas. And so yeah, it's always worth reading other people's comments, because they come out with some really, really good ideas, and I really do appreciate it. And yeah, I'm going to try some of the things that people have mentioned as well, because they're really good. Okay, so that is project number 1, our little spooky ghost. And then from autumn and Halloween, we're moving on to, can you tell, red ribbons, Christmas. And this was something that I thought, oh, now there's a really good idea. Okay, oh, these are bigger than I expected. Wow, right, where's the opening? Come on, I want to get into these to have a look. Goodness me. So this is a set of 4. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 lovely long pieces of satin ribbon. It's got a little bit creased. I would possibly just iron this before you use it. I find the best way actually is to put, if you've got any hair straighteners, just put them on the lowest setting you can, or just before it heats up, or just as it's cooling down, and just run it along the length of your ribbon, and it saves getting your iron out, and that it just straightens up your ribbon. Yeah, because they've just got a little bit creased. I'm very fussy on things like that. I can't be doing with a creased ribbon. you can iron them now, and then once it's done, just maybe put them on a piece of cardboard or something, or on a roll, just so that it keeps it flat and nice and straight. They're easier to tie, aren't they, things when the ribbon's straight. When you've got the kinks in, you tend to find that you can't quite get your little bunny ears, your little bow, closed properly. Maybe it's just me. Okay. So again, this one are all, well, these are all crystals, because there are 4 of them. Just pop over there a second. Let me put that out of the way over there. Tape measure will put you there for now. Remember where that is, because I'm probably going to say, where did I put my tape measure in a minute? We've got a pen, butter and wax, your little standard toolkit. And these are actually little photograph frames. So how do these work? The set of 4 are $10.99. I say they're a lot bigger than I was expecting. I was thinking I was going to have to get some little photographs about that big. So, let me have a look. You don't get it from the back. So, is the front sticky? So, then you're just going to stick your photograph on the front. Is that what we do? Let me have a look. Yep. So, what you... What I would suggest then for getting the right size for your photographs on these, Unless I think of anything else, it's possibly getting a piece of tracing paper and just drawing the size out, the shape out. And then if you've got a cutting machine, fantastic, scan it in and get it to cut it out so it's exact. Or then just cut it around on the back of your photograph so that you've got your right size. You have got a little bit of leeway on your size there, because there is like that, you can see, sorry, go a bit closer, that white edge there. So you don't want to be going over your gems, but we have got a little bit of leeway there and a little bit on the scarf. I did think there might be pockets that you put your photograph in on the back, but then that would make them a lot more money because there'd be a lot more involved. So yeah, you can just put, I mean, to be honest, you could even put another sticker on there, like a snowflake sticker or something. It doesn't have to be a photograph, but they are designed as Christmas photo frames. And then see, you've got your lovely red satin ribbon to go on it. Just realised that this snowman is holding a cardinal in his hand as well. Or the cardinal's landed on the branch hand of the snowman. It's a lovely happy face. It's got little pink cheeks, but it is cold when you're a snowman, so I can imagine he's got pink cheeks. He's got his little carrot nose, he's got his hat on and his little scarf as well. But yeah, I just thought they were a little bit different to do. Nice clear drill field, not too many colours to do. So great for children. And now then, you would have to seal it. But don't seal over your photograph, because I don't think the sealer would work very well on photographs. I've never tried it, so it's not something I can recommend. I may try it one day just to see what actually happens if you do seal a photograph. But they're actually quite light as well. They're quite thin. They're only probably about a couple of millimetres, if that thickness. Quite bendable as well, so there's quite a bit of give in them. And they're not real brittle, so, you know, quite durable as well for bringing out each year. But I said they're a lot bigger than I thought. I thought they were going to be small and have a little pocket in the back. But actually, no, I'm liking this because you can use a bigger photograph. Okay, so that's Snowman. We've then got a Santa. Now, this is more of just a round one. They've actually got four figures, just very ghosted in the background there. You can see sort of like a dummy photograph that they've put in, so you can see them. And yeah, he's got his little red nose and his standard Santa outfit on, and then he's got some little stars on his belt down here, look, as well. So he's quite cute. He's only got a small mouth. I might have to just put an extra gem either side to make him a smiley Santa. We like smiles. And then we have, oops, can't pick them up, a lovely present. So this one is more of a square photograph. You could put school photographs in this. Imagine that, and then bringing it out year after year just to embarrass your kids when they get older. Maybe just me then, to embarrass them. So yeah, it's a nice present with a big bow on it. They're not double-sided, so you can see the photograph on the other side there, can't you? So I mean, you could even just stick them on the wall. You don't have to, well, I don't know, I think they're quite big to hang from a tree, to be honest. You could put them on a mantelpiece. Again, just put them in like a little stand or something. You get like little plate stands, can't you, as well, to stand them on. But yeah, or just put a little V of cardboard on the back, like one of the like school photograph frames, where it just pulls out and you just have a little V so that it stands up on its own. But so that's a square one. And then we've got the wreath one. Oh, that's pretty. I like that. A lot of decoration on it, and I like the scallop edge as well. And that one's just a complete circle, just to go in the middle there. So, yeah, I just thought there was something a little bit different, new out. And I think for a set of four, lovely Christmassy colours. They're my colours, traditional red, green and goldy type colours. And your snowman and your Santa. And so we've got a cardinal on that one. Right, I can remember where I put my tape measure. Oh dear. So they're about 6-ish inches, which is 15 centimetres. That one's still about 6-ish inches. Let's have a look at the height of him. Yeah, so they're all roughly 6 inches, 15 centimetres. So they're a good big size. Go from there to there. Yeah, they're all more or less the same size. the photographs, let me have a look. That one is about 6 centimetres, 2¼ inches by about just under 3 inches, which is 7 centimetres. And snowman is again about 6 centimetres, just under 3 inches. And that one's about 7-ish centimetres, which is about 2¾ inches. So they're all more or less the same size, yeah, 7 centimetres. So not too bad, you know, if you've got like a group shot or a headshot, just to pop in one of these as a little keepsake, a little photograph. Yeah, liking those, really liking those. Oh, thank you, Paint Somewhere. I've really enjoyed looking at these and really loving the new products that are coming out. I'm very, very impressed. Okay, let me just wind these ribbons up a little bit and put them in the bag. I'm just going to try and roll them. Talk amongst yourselves while I just do it. Okay, see if we can do this. Just keep them a little bit flatter. Oh, that's better, look. Just try and keep them in check a little bit. Okay. Yeah, one's just a little bit shorter than the others, but that's fine. So I think I'm going to just pop those in a grip seal bag for now. A little bit bigger one. So it just keeps them together as well and stops the ends from getting caught on anything and fraying. So there you are. There you are, little ribbons. That's just corralled you all up and got you nice and neat in a bag. Okay, so we've had quite a bit of fun with these. A little bit of Christmas and a little bit of Halloween and then a quirky pen. Okay, well, a huge thank you, Paint Somewhere, for sending me these. Do go and check out the website and check out the special offers and go and see all these new items that they've got coming in. If you've enjoyed looking at these with me, then as always, a thumbs up is very much appreciated. Any comments or questions in the comments down below. And if you want to come back and see what I get up to next and join our little family, then if you press that subscribe button down in this corner and the all notifications bell that pops up, you'll be notified when any of my videos come up, so you're not going to miss anything. Yay! Okay, thanks ever so much for stopping by, and I do hope to see you all again soon. Bye for now.